Hi there, I'm Chef Ani, and today we are making a super exciting recipe. This is my one pot tomato and olive summer pasta. This is one for the books. I love it, and it's so simple to make because it's all made in one pot. It really can't get much easier than this. So simple that you can even make it outside. So enough talking, let's get cooking. So we're going to get started with our pasta. Today I'm using linguine pasta, but you could use a variety of pasta. You could use whole grain pasta to get more whole grains into your life. You could use any type of shape of pasta. You just want to adjust the cooking time so that the pasta will cook. Next, we're going to add some cherry tomatoes. I just like to slice them in half like this. Now, if you don't have green olives, you could use black olives, but I like to use green olives because they have a very mild flavor, and they're also pretty to look at. The next thing we're going to add is some capers. This gives a really nice pop of flavor to this pasta. And we're just going to really thinly slice some garlic and put that in as well. And we're also going to add some crushed red pepper, a little bit of salt, and we're going to add a little bit of oil. And now we're going to add in our water. Just pour it right on in there. I remember the first time I did a one pot pasta dish, I said, this isn't gonna work. And I was so blown away of how easy it was to do that now I make it quite a bit. I love one pot pasta dishes. And actually, I've heard recently that many of you have tried my one pot pasta dishes. We try to do one every summer. So I know we have a one pot pasta. It has onion and different things in there. So if you'd like to check out that one. We also have a mushroom stroganoff one pot pasta dish, and we have an eggplant pasta dish, which is amazing. So if you'd like to try any of those, I'll put links down below. And of course you can get the detailed recipe to this one down in the description box below. So I'm going to bring this up to a boil, and I'm going to add in just a little bit of Better Than Bouillon. This just helps kind of round out that flavoring, give it a good base. You want to make sure to get in here and stir it though through the cooking process. Otherwise you might have pasta that clumps together or pasta that isn't cooked. So you want to make sure to stir it every once in a while. So our pasta is almost done. We are going to just chop up some herbs to really just bring this dish together. I have some basil here, which is my favorite, right out of my garden over there. And then I have some parsley as well. And then we're just going to add in all those herbs. Hello, doesn't that look beautiful? This is gonna make the people in your life very happy. I have a beautiful pasta dish here, and we are just going to serve this up. All right, this is so beautiful. I just cannot wait to just dig in here and try it. Kaya's here, do you want some?
Yeah?
Get me a plate. That's one you have to just sit down for. That's just so good. This one has...
It looks like a Mediterranean pasta.
Kinda does, doesn't it? All right, new name. It's now called Mediterranean pasta dish. Kaya just named it. Thank you, kiddo. Oh, I love this pasta. It is delicious. The sauce is what really brings it together. You know, those little bites of capers, the cherry tomatoes, the fresh basil. I mean, what is there not to love about this dish? It is gorgeous, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. Do you like it, kiddo?
Yeah.
Yeah? It's good? Fantastic. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe to join me in this adventure to eat healthier, one recipe at a time. And I look forward to seeing you next Wednesday with another video.
I want more.
You want more?
Yeah.